Hello, Virtual Wind Ensemble members. It is great to tell you that phase one of our project was a big success. I hope you've had a chance to see the video already, but if not, it is included in the email you're receiving that also sent you this intro video. But the purpose of this video is to help us make a few improvements on some things I learned during phase one. Specifically, there are three things I'd like you to remember before you begin the recording process. And then there are three things that I'll review that I'd like you to make sure you're doing during the recording process. But first, number one, before you begin, please check your surroundings and find the quietest available area that you can possibly get to. I understand that we're in a lot of different scenarios and in extraordinary situations, but do the best you can. If there is a light on that's buzzing or a fan on, if you can turn those things off, it would be very, very helpful. Second, please make sure that you practice through with the conducting video to make sure that you've found all the correct notes, but that you're also following the tempo changes and the dynamic changes that I've tried to indicate. And third, please make sure that you explore the best possible placement for your recording device. Typically, I think that the microphone on your earbuds or the microphone on your phone is going to be a better microphone than on most laptops. So please make sure that you have placed that recording device somewhere in the room where you have your best microphone option, but you also have the best distance from the microphone to your instrument option. Some instruments can be too loud or too soft depending on how close they are. So please experiment to see what your best sound placement is for your recording device. Now, here are three things I'd like you to make sure you're doing during the recording process. Number one, it's very important that we all clap our hands loudly at the indicated place at the beginning of the conducting video. That clap is going to create an audible signal that I can track in your video when I'm doing all of the audio and video mixing. I need to have that sound in order to sync everyone's video together. Number two, please make sure that you wear headphones. You must wear the headphones, not only just because it will cancel out the sound that might be on the conducting video that we don't want to get into your personal recording, but also when you listen to the conducting video and the piano accompaniment, that will all give us a common tonal center that we can all tune to as we play. And if you're just trying to tune to your instrument in your mind, it's going to be hard to find that common ground if you don't have those headphones on to hear the piano. My apologies, in this shelter in place era that we're in, my piano is a little out of tune, but I hope you'll be able to find the in-tune tonal center in all of the chords that I'm accompanying for that video. And then finally, number three, as you record, I know it's a weird time. I know this is, there's a lot on our minds, but I invite you to lose yourself in this moment and savor the moment we're making music together, even though it's virtually, even though it's miles apart. The end product has amazing potential to sound like we are together, and in a way, we are together. So we're together right now, even watching this video. So please put the same heart and soul into your performance that you would put into a live performance, and we'll make the most of it that we can. Thank you.